Welcome back to my channel. If you are new to this channel, then make sure you click the subscribe button just below, then you can get the latest updates from our channel. So moving on, now we are going to see about Maurya Udyog Limited latest update. So what is so important about Maurya Udyog Limited latest update? One of our subscribers asked, can you say about the balance sheet of Maurya Udyog Limited? And here is my analysis towards this company, Maurya Udyog Limited. First and foremost, if you see, the share capital is 13.32. That means the investors who have given their money, that is shareholder funds. As you can see, the reserve and surplus has been increasing steadily from 85 crores, 115 crores, 123 crores, 128 crores. From seeing this, you will be happy, right? That's not the fact, guys. The main thing to note is that long-term borrowings is also increased. For example, in 2015, it was just 62 crore. In 2019, it is 118 crore. The borrowings has also increased. Now, moving on, long-term borrowing is not a very important factor to note, guys. Long-term means we should pay the debt in long-term. But moving on, if you see the short-term borrowings, guys, it is 140 crores. It is very, very negative, guys. Why we say later? And also, if you see, short-term borrowings is on the same range, and trade payables also on the same range. Trade payables does not matter because they can easily pay off. But if you get the short-term borrowings, that is very, very hindrance to this. So moving on, assets. If you're moving on the assets, this is 2015, guys, and this is 2019, the year has been cut. If you see that there has been a constant decrease in the tangible assets over a period of time, guys. That is the main point to be noted. For a company, you want to increase its capacity, want to increase its tangible assets. Tangible assets mean like machines, building, etc. But it has been keep on decreasing. No, moving on with current. Let's see the current assets of this company. The inventory has been increasing steadily. That is a negative point to note, because so much of inventory means the product has not been sold off very quickly. But it is not a matter for a company having a trade receivable of 364 crores. That is not a matter. I previously told the short-term borrowings are very, very important point to note, because once again, I show the short term borrowings is 140 crores, added to trade payable is having 211 crores. Now, if we add short term borrowings, they only have 15.48 crores in cash to pay the amount of debt. Therefore, they want to sell their assets in order to repay the assets or non current investment. They have to pay, they want to pay the short term borrowing, they have to pay like this. No, that is not possible. Also, the non current investments is also very less, guys. If you take non-current investments and also cash and cash equivalents, total is coming to 19 crores. When you compare with the short-term borrowings, it is 140 crores. That is the main point. Where is 19 crores and where is 140 crores? That is a point to be noted. And if you coming on, I will also show the cash flow of the company. Why I'm showing whether a company is earning loss. See, unless and until the company's operating profit is positive, then we can go and invest. Now, what is operating cash flow? Operating cash flow is nothing but the amount that the company earns from operating this, operating their day-to-day business. What is Maurya Udyog day-to-day business? It is nothing but preparation of the gas cylinders and selling of it. Now, if we come here, you can see that operating cash flow is on negative figure for this September ended quarter, guys. As you can see here, 41 crores in negative figure. That is the main point to be noted. And if you're moving on, the slide is going to end, sir. So, guys, this is the analysis I am showing you on Maurya Udyog Limited. Also, your point to be noted is they have taken borrowings of 37.12 crore in this quarter. As you can see here, proceeds from borrowings is 37 crores. 3712.57 lakhs means 37 crores they have taken borrowings, guys. So please make sure to click the subscribe button and comment below, guys.